morning on Fox, a medical miracle that by all accounts never should have happened.
The story goes back a little more than 2 years ago when a brutal attack left a man in a coma. Would he survive? Rob Piercy tonight with the man who helped bring him back from the brink of death.
February 24th, 2004, the day Kelly Isaka believes he was resurrected from a sure death.
They have hit me. They have hit my older brother.
Isaka and his brother had come to this park to talk to people who had vandalized a relative's home. They had no sooner walked up when four men attacked.
And I see my older brother, he fall down.
Isaka ran to his brother to help, but they were outnumbered 2-1, and the men had a weapon, a shovel. Isaka never saw it coming. Laying bloody on the ground, the men repositioned Isaka's head and began bashing his skull with the shovel. In the distance, he heard shouting from the wife of one of his attackers.
His wife started yelling to kill them.
A few more minutes of beating, and they likely would have.
And thanks God, somebody from the neighborhood, they called the police.
Paramedics rushed Kelly here to Good Samaritan Hospital in Central Phoenix. He was alive, but his injuries were so severe, doctors put his chances of survival at less than 10%.
10%. 10% chance of survival, 90% chance of death.
Josie Isaka is Kelly's wife. With her husband lying in a hospital bed, doctors gave her the rundown of his injuries.
His whole face has been fractured. He has bleeding and damage to his brain, and that he may not survive the night.
These are a few of the pictures taken of Kelly that night, but most of the photographs are simply too gruesome to show.
I almost fainted, because if you were to see him laying on the bed, I did not recognize him. He's my husband.
Fearing this night would be their last together, Josie held vigil at Kelly's side. If doctors couldn't save him, who could? The answer came from a family friend who recommended well-known healer Jerry Wills.
I'm just thinking, okay, it's another person to come and pray over Kelly, so hey, why not?
I'll never forget when I walked in, Kelly was lying there on this bed and just in an awful condition.
Jerry, who lives in Peoria, is known the world over for being able to cure people's ailments, chronic pain, sickness, disease. This, however, was an entirely new challenge. His giant 6.5-foot frame towering above Kelly's bed, Jerry raised his hands and began focusing. Josie watched.
The whole room just seemed like it just fell silent.
With powers he can't entirely explain, Jerry was taken to another place where he found Kelly waiting in a large grassy field.
When I saw him there, I basically just let him know that it was all right to come back.
Back from the brink of death, Jerry then focused on healing some of Kelly's internal injuries.
It would be very easy for me to take credit, but the truth is, it's God's work, not mine.
As quickly as he began, Jerry was done.
He did his little procedure, and when he finished, he told me, "Don't worry about it. Your husband's going to be fine."
I told Josie, he's going to have a pretty bad headache when he wakes up, and he's got a bit of a long road ahead of him to get fully recovered, you know, to where he's up and around and moving. But this is going to turn out just fine.
A longtime friend of Jerry's who'd come along was stunned.
I was amazed to hear what was coming out of Jerry's mouth, you know, in this situation, because I didn't think that this guy was going to make it.
Then Jerry told Josie about finding Kelly in that field. She would hear that story once more when her husband awoke from his coma.
I told her to take me to the elevator. I want to go home. I don't want to stay in the hospital.
Just as Jerry had predicted, Kelly had survived. His doctors couldn't make sense of his progress.
They couldn't believe that he was progressing as fast as he was. They totally, completely thought he was going to die.
Given just a 10% chance to live, Kelly told his wife it was a dream that had led him back to her.
I have a dream that I see a tall white man. And she told me, oh yeah, what's his name? And I told him, I don't know. I told my wife, I don't know. And he grabbed my hand and he told me, I go in the wrong way, follow him.
It was then that Josie told her husband of Jerry Wills, a gentle giant who did what this family believes doctors could not have done on their own.
I was feel grateful. I was feel thankful because of what he did.
Yeah, I'm very humbled by it. It's really a good feeling to know that you've made a difference in another person's life in such a positive way.
Rob Piercy.
I have a front row seat to miracles.
Fox 10 News.
Kelly suffered permanent damage to his left eye, but no brain damage, which is what doctors feared most. As for the people who attacked him 2 years ago, one of them, a juvenile at the time, was sentenced to 6 months in jail plus probation. The other three men have yet to go to trial.